Have you ever found yourself as the first person at the scene of a car crash? Did you freeze in panic or were you a hero?
With thousands of Kiwis on the roads this summer, I thought we could all do with a refresher course from the experts at St John. Tonight on Hilary Helps, we give you some practical advice on what to do if you're first on the scene of a car accident. Let's go, Lisa.
This is Lisa. She's been to lots of accidents, and she knows what to do if you find yourself on the scene of one. First, find out where you are.
Sometimes you can be on those big highways and you don't really know what town you've come out of or what town you're going into, so having a little bit of an awareness about where you are so that when you call 111, it's easy for us to know where we're going.
Don't get yourself run over.
So if you're on one of those blind corners and you've come across a crash, then the next car coming in is also going to come around that same blind corner. So being careful about where you are and making sure that you're not going to be injured in it as well.
Keep a lid on the emotion and call 111.
As bad luck would have it, Lisa, someone's just had an accident here. I'm just going to see if he's alright.
What? 111.
What? Before I even see if he's okay?
Yep.
Okay.
We need to know where you are at this point.
Okay. 111.
Okay, tell me exactly what happened. How many people are hurt? How old is he? Is he awake? Is he breathing?
And now they're going to be asking you more questions about the scene and about the patients.
Oh, he's not in a good way.
So at this point they're going to ask you to assess his airway, his breathing and his circulation.
Can I put them on speakerphone
so absolutely.
They can hear? Okay.
Yep. So they're going to want to see, has he got a pulse?
Well, he's still warm. There's a good pulse there.
If the patient's breathing, keep them still and don't get them out of the car.
Gently pop his head back so that his airway's nice and open.
Okay. Pop his head back.
That's
like
it.
That.
Yep. Now see if he's talking to you and reassure him.
Can you hear me, sir?
But he's not talking to you, but reassure him anyway.
If the patient doesn't have a pulse, pull them from the car and do CPR.
Like anyone that's unconscious and is unresponsive, then CPR is exactly what we want. 30 to 2, no matter who.
Excellent. Remember that, 30 to 2, no matter who. And the concern that you might be doing them some damage to their ribs or anything?
Yeah, they're dead already.
Okay.
So can't make dead more dead.
And what about sort of doing, stopping and giving them some mouth to mouth?
Compressions are really important, but so is ventilation.
Since our dummy is unsterilised, I'm not going to demonstrate that. And another life saved.
Saving lives takes preparation.
Hey Lisa, can I help you by driving this one?
No, you can.
Oh, the ambulances need to be ship-shaped too.
Just checking the tyre pressure. Hey Lisa, can I help by turning on the lights?
Okay.
She said yes. Thanks, just hoist that up. Because you've got to do the spare.
Okay.
And as luck would have it, this one's really grubby. Like really grubby.
Can I turn the siren on?
Go for it. Mind the pole, just out saving lives.
Show that
no biggie. Well, Mo, you've been given the once over by St John. You're all good to go.
Thanks for your help, Hilary.
Oh, it's my absolute pleasure. Have a good day. Saved another life. Now, one of the biggest mistakes that people actually make, and I can imagine being this situation as well, pulling people from the vehicles when they don't need to, particularly when they think the car's on fire, because airbags let off gas. A burst radiator can let off steam, so people freak out and they go, the car's on fire, I've got to get these people out. So take a moment, take a deep breath, and just have a look for flames, because often a car is not on fire and people are pulling people out of cars and actually doing them a lot of damage. So don't do that.
I see how slow you were to get your mouth around the... Didn't want to do the mouth-to-mouth.
A lot of people had done mouth-to-mouth on Anne.
Well, I'm sure
I got there.
What about the person who's in the car? A couple of people would have done mouth-to-mouth on them a couple of times, no doubt.
Possibly.
Just before we go, a couple of things quickly. We've got a double pass to the Auckland and to the Dunedin Farewell Yellow Brick Road shows to give away. So, the Ruby tickets too, they're worth $249 a pop, which is quite something. Just tell us why you want to go on our Facebook page, and Cassie's going to pick those out for us.
It's
also,
all loaded up.
Yeah, it's going to be, it'll be an amazing gig. And tomorrow, of course, we've got the Dark Destroyer, Sean Wallace.
From The Chase
on the show, live on the couch.
He's a bit scary. Mm. We're not going to have to do a quiz show with him, are we?
We are doing a mastermind with him, actually. We are. Those are our people
awesome.
Today.